Ladies and gentlemen, this is professional barbecue.
This is sexy.
Give it to God.
Barbecue!
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 That's what I'm talking about! Let's go barbecue!
Jesus on three. One, two, three.
Jesus!
Woo!
Yes!
One, two, three.
Jesus!
Woo!
Jesus!
Woo!
Jesus!
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 Jesus on three. One, two, three.
Jesus!
We're gonna need a bigger boat.
It's part of the great design. Part of the great design.
Well, good morning. Here in Demopolis, Alabama. For Christmas on the River, praise the Lord. By the way, it's Brooke's birthday today, so go out and thank somebody. I just wanted to share this because it's just incredible. And I hope you find it that way too. But I was up early about 4:30 and had to go to Walmart, pick up some stuff. And I stopped by and I figured I'd fill up my gas tank and stopped at a Texaco station just on the outside of town, just like right at the edge of town. And as I'm filling up, I'm looking and there are just people one after the other going into this, you know, Texaco food mart. It's just a little food mart. And I noticed a counter back there where they're obviously serving some breakfast. And as I'm filling up, I mean, more cars are pulling in, people are moving out, and it's like, I mean, the crowd is huge going into here, and I'm thinking to myself, man, I gotta get some breakfast in there. And so anyways, I filled up, and the line was out the door on the back side. And so I went to Walmart, and I said, man, I gotta go see what's going on there. So I went over, and I go in, and it's like the melting pot of Demopolis. I mean, you got guys in suits, you got truck drivers, you got trucks parked all over, you know, logging trucks and service trucks and, you know, guys of all types, frames, backgrounds, black, white, rich, poor. I mean, everybody's in there, you know, lined up and getting their breakfast. So I get in line. And then I start looking around and there's like, I mean, scrambled eggs and fried eggs and ham and sausage and potatoes and pork chops and fried chicken. And so I'm starting to look and I said, like, okay, where's the menu? And I don't see a menu. And I'm like, oh man, this is a seriously local joint. So it's like, you got to know what you're going to order. And so I'm paying attention and listening as guys ahead of me are ordering. I'm thinking like, okay, I got a strategy and I got a plan. So I said, I need biscuit and gravy. And then I said, I need some Connect sausage. That was like, they didn't know I wasn't local, because when you say Connect, it's like, okay, you're from around here. And so anyways, I, you know, it's just a simple, no frills, wonderful little start to the morning breakfast. And I'm just blown away at, you know, how cool it is. Simple. And just quiet, and everybody's just getting their breakfast and eating it and starting the day, and the ladies behind the counter just working their butt off. And told the thank you fairy story, and it was just like, you know, I know it doesn't sound like much, but that was a really cool experience. Simply cool. And I just wanted to share that with you, because God blesses us in very, very interesting ways. So anyways, that's my breakfast. Gotta eat it. We're over here at Bayou Boogie, his setup, and we're a little concerned right now because there's shoes, but there's no Barry. There's a pit, a motorhome, and shoes, but no Barry. Okay, there's a cooler, which means that's a good sign, which means he returned, but we're still worried about this. Where is Barry? How's that? Is that cool or what? Okay, check it out. These are instruments in the park. Check it out. Yes. Tell the barbecue pitmaster, what is it that's on your dream list? Give it to God. Barbecue. Yes. What a lovely thought.
Ladies and gentlemen, Adam Gutro. Needs no introduction. One of the elite growing, cook everything, do it great. But I just heard a story about why he is such a phenomenal cook overall. So I'm going to have him tell you.
Well, I'm sitting here eating gumbo. Got my dad right there, and I was just telling Jeff that when I was a kid, my grandmother used to strain this juice and put it in my bottle for me. So I've been eating this gumbo since I was a little tiny.
Straining gumbo juice and putting it in a bottle.
True story.
Only in Louisiana.
Only in Louisiana.
Whatever. Let the record show that I asked Bobby to bring that to you.
Yep. And I did. And I came and knocked on your door. But like a vampire, you was sleeping and probably didn't get up.
I don't think he did his. I don't think he did his due diligence.
Is how he knocked.
No. I knocked.
I saw him when he walked by your trailer. He went like this.
I mean, aren't there other options than giving it away? I mean, if it's designated for me.
Here's the deal. I figured you were either sound asleep or you was off somewhere doing some kind of TV interview. Maybe live camera stuff.
I can't fight that one.
You know, didn't really know where you were at, so.
It's not that she would hog the camera.
With friends like this, you know what I'm saying, you know?
Same party as last year. Lots of folks just partying, having a good time.
And when I say a feast, I mean a feast that, like the word says, goes beyond understanding. I didn't lose a night of sleep over it. You know, I mean, I'm sure my wife did, because she has other family members battling cancer as well. But God gave me such a peace about it from the beginning that, I mean, I just can't explain. And unless you know Christ, you'll never understand that peace. You'll never, ever have that peace. There is no peace here on this earth. We see this this world is turned upside down. It's just like the Bible says, good's being called evil and evil is being called good nowadays. We know that we're facing end times. Anyway, when I was here this time last year, I think we had one or two more treatments to do. But we did a PET scan not long after I left up here, I think about the middle of December. So from September, when I found out I had it, had the surgery to remove a tumor, to about the middle of December after the PET scan, I was cancer free. So it's nothing but God. The doctors treat, but Jesus heals. Amen. You put your faith in Him in anything. He wants us to put that faith in. These shoulders aren't meant to carry the burden that we carry. But I can tell you, through Jesus Christ, it's not that you're not going to see trials, because you're going to. It's just like a refiner's fire. When they refine that gold, they refine that silver.
dross rises to the top, then it becomes more pure. The things that we go through, the trials, the sicknesses, the events that happen in our life that we ask God, why did this happen? Sometimes we need to ask, what is it that you want me to take from this? Because that's Him using the refining fire to get that dross out of our life, and we become more and more like Him. Now, it's not to say, like I said, that we're not going to have problems. When we put our faith there, He's our foundation. He is the beginning of our new life. And guys, whether it be cancer, whether it be job, whether it be family, whether it be whatever it is, He's going to take care of it, take care of us through it all. And y'all continue to pray for Alan, Shelly's mom and dad as well, battling cancer. Just continue to pray. Because I know we say that, we use that term almost like a like an afterthought. I'm going to be praying for you. But do we actually take it to the Lord and pray? And that's something that we need to be, to have resolve about doing. And let's take it to Him. Because I'm telling you, guys, prayer works. It absolutely does. It's not so much on our part as what we do, but what the God that we serve does when we're faithful in Him. So thank y'all tomorrow.
Come on, get in here. Get in here. Get in here. Hand in here, just like a huddle. We're going to break Jesus on three. We want to say it nice and loud. Get a hand in here. Get a hand on somebody. If we don't do it loud enough, we're doing it again. Got it? Jesus on three. One, two, three.
Jesus!
Woo!
All right, break it up here.
Okay, it's time for the song.
Who let the dogs out?
To God, barbecue.
That's what I'm talking about.